Yeah, Lord, we know we can't do nothing on our own. Yes, yeah, so protect us with the blood of Jesus Christ and grace. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Today I'd like to use the word subject. The Lord is my shepherd.
Is that right?
The Lord is my shepherd. Uh-huh. And the text is found in Psalm 23. Amen. Amen. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. Amen.
Amen.
He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He restores my soul. He guides me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You have anointed my head
with oil.
My cup overflows. Surely, goodness and love kindness will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Amen.
Amen. Now let me elaborate on the first verse. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. What is a shepherd? A shepherd is a person or people who oversees the flock. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
The flock.
Yeah, yeah.
Now, anybody else not going to oversee the flock like that, amen,
right,
when danger comes, amen. But the shepherd stays right there, amen. Even when danger appears, that is the shepherd's job to watch the flock. Can I get a witness?
Right.
Yeah. And in this spiritual realm, it is Jesus Christ, our shepherd, amen. And then he has appointed the pastors as the shepherd to oversee the flock. Can I get a witness?
Right.
So that's the pastor's job, is to oversee the flock and not leave the flock alone. Can I get a witness?
Right.
And then let me elaborate again on the second verse. He makes me lie down in green pastures. Amen. Green pastures. He just overflows with his blessings. Can I get a witness?
Right.
He just overflows up. And then he leads me beside quiet waters. One particular Bible says still waters. Amen. What is still water? Peace.
Peace.
Do you have that peace within? That peace which passes all
understanding,
amen.
Amen.
The peace of Jesus Christ, amen, which God gives to us, amen. Do you have peace within? Some people just don't have peace within, huh?
That's right.
They're trying to find every other thing to replace that peace within, amen. But you don't get peace until you accept Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. Huh? Isn't that some good peace right there? That's a spiritual peace, amen. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Amen. So, he restores my soul, amen. My soul, amen. You know, sometimes we get a little burden, don't we? Sometimes we feel like giving up, amen. But Jesus said, what? I'll never leave you.
Nor forsake you.
Nor forsake you, amen. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
And even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, amen. You know, I'm not fearing nothing because I know Jesus Christ got my back. He got your back, amen. So you don't have to be afraid. We got a lot of afraid people today, afraid to do this, afraid to die, afraid to live, amen. Afraid to be blessed, amen. Afraid of a lot of things, amen. But the Bible instructs us, do not be afraid, amen. Because Jesus Christ, that perfect shepherd, amen. He's abiding within us, amen. He's abiding within our household, amen. He's abiding within the true church, amen. The Lord is my shepherd. I I shall not want. Amen. I've been saying that verse ever since I was about, 5 years old, amen. Every now and then when I get, not at peace, I say that verse. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. I just keep saying that, amen. All these years, amen. I'm not going to tell you how old I am right now, amen. But all these years, I say that verse quite often, amen. When I get into this trip, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want, amen. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want, amen. And then one day they told me, stop saying that verse at the table, amen. See, they said say something else, amen. But I kept saying that verse, amen. The Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want. They ain't shut me up yet, y'all, amen.
Amen.
They ain't shut me up yet. That verse is still in my mind, amen. See, I had graduated from saying Jesus wept. Amen. Remember that one? Uh-huh. Jesus wept. The shortest verse in the Bible, amen. Uh-huh. Then I graduated to the Lord and my shepherd, and I shall not want, amen. Uh-huh. You know, King David, you know, he kept saying that, you know, even though his household was in an uproar, amen. You know, they sought to kill him, amen. Uh-huh. King Saul and all of them, amen. Uh-huh. They sought to take David out. But David remembered the Lord, amen. He remembered the true shepherd, amen. He remembered the Lord. The shepherd boy, remember that. The Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want, amen. He remembered that when he slew the bear, amen. When he slew Goliath, amen. He remembered that the Lord was his shepherd, amen. He remembered, amen, when the Philistine army came up, a great host, all of them giants, amen. He remembered that the Lord told him, yeah, I'm not going to leave you, King David. I'm the shepherd, amen. He remembered the true shepherd, amen. Do you remember the true shepherd? Even though we got some Goliaths walking around here trying to slay us in situations, amen, with their slanderous ways, amen. But do you remember? The Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want. Amen. Amen. Because you see, it states here, your rod and your staff, they comfort me, amen. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies, amen. You know how it is, the naysayers, amen. Talking about they're not gonna make it, amen. But God still be setting that table, amen. Can I get a witness? Amen. God still be preparing a way out of no way, mentally and physically, amen. My table is set, amen. Is your table set? Y'all ain't gonna pray with me, amen. Even in your home, amen, they keep talking. How they gonna make it now, amen? They got all this going on, but I ain't missed a meal yet. How about I gain some weight? Amen. Because the Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want. Amen. The people keep saying, how they going to make it? Now they got too much stuff going on. Where the meals going to come from? How about I got more meals now? Y'all ain't going to pray with me. How about I got more blessings now? Y'all going to pray with me? Amen. How about stuff that be coming from nowhere? You know what I'm saying? You know, it didn't come then when I ain't have all that stuff going on. But now all this stuff is going on. All this noise, y'all ain't going to pray with me. All this commotion and people looking and saying, how they making it there? But you just don't know what I've been through. My God just keeps on making a way out of nowhere. Y'all going to pray with me? Out of nowhere. He keeps on waking me up and starting me on my way. Y'all going to pray with me? And those blessings just keep on coming, amen. You know, those people thought those blessings were going to get shut down, amen. But I know my shepherd, amen. Do you know your shepherd?
Amen.
Amen. Yeah, the good shepherd, amen. Can I get out? I believe this thing a priest this morning, amen.
That's all right.
You know, and then it says, you have anointed my head with oil, amen. You need the anointing of God, amen. The anointing, you speak, you need to pray for the anointing of God. The anointing of God breaks yokes. Say, y'all gonna pray with
yes,
me?
Yes, it does.
The anointing of God breaks wicked spirits.
Yes, it does.
The anointing of God, amen. You see, King David had the anointing, amen. Saul didn't have that anointing because it left him, amen. But King David had the anointing. That's how he can slew the Goliath. That's how he killed the bear. That's how he killed the lamb. Because he had the true anointing of God, amen. So you, my brothers and sisters, you need to pray for the anointing of God, amen. I don't care how good you can do it. I don't care how good your gift is. You need the anointing of God, amen. Can I get a witness? The anointing of God. Y'all gonna pray with me? The anointing of God, amen. Yeah.
Amen.
Can I get a witness?
Amen.
And then, my cup overflows. Uh-huh. Do your cup overflow tomorrow?
Yes.
Huh? I'm not talking about in a physical sense. Amen. But I'm talking about in a spiritual sense. Amen. And then it says, look at this verb. Truly. Goodness.
Mama.
And love and kindness will follow me all the days of my life. Amen. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. This is what King David said. Forever. Amen. Somebody said, don't take all of that. Yeah, it do. Can I get a witness? Somebody say, I don't have to go down to the church house over here. Over there. But yeah, you do. Amen. To get the true blessings of God, you know, it has an ark, a safety over there. Amen. Amen. The true church has an ark, a safety over it. Y'all want to pray with me?